Aloha, Summoners! We are going to kick back and surf the waves with our favorite surfer and representing the horse zodiac, Kahiki the Hickey! No, not that Hickey, this Hickey! So apparently Gumi likes swimming horses, who are quite graceful in the water actually. Hence why they chose the water unit as a horse. And I'm very free to make this meme. Oh wait, too much? Okay, let's tone it down.
I surf till the sun sets beyond the horizon.
Now, let's start talking about Kahiki. Leader skill, Endless Summer. You have stats and critical rate for water types only. Sunscreen, DOT reduction, spark critical, spark damage, and PvP bonus points. This LS is similar to other VA units. If you want to complement a more damage-based orientated LS, then sure, use it. There are better leader skills out there though. However, if you want to climb arena and get the mad points, then make sure you set this guy to lead. Extra skill, Spirited Freedom by Murkoff. You get attack, critical rate, DOT reduction, BB fill rate down counter, spark, and negate status ailments. The only reason I like this is because it represents Murkoff. Brave Burst, White Water Surge. You get an HP scaling AoE, attack, defense, reduction, counter, and infliction, 30% DOT reduction, tri-stat based on max HP and max HP reduction. This Brave Burst is PvP orientated. You could do them BB9 memes if you want, even though his enhancements say otherwise. The main thing you will get out of this is the tri-stat based on max HP, which is one of the best converts because it makes your stats do this.
It's over 9,000!
Super Brave Burst rolling in the deep! Riptide. You get a double attack AoE and single target, spark healing, spark crit, tri-stats, and spark up for being blue, da ba dee da doo da. Anyways, this SBB is basically Kahiki's bread and butter and probably the main thing you're going to be using anyways. Assuming your sparking is on point, you get a lot of benefits. Ultimate Brave Burst, Cresting Crash. You get an HP scaling AoE, attack and defense down infliction, 100% DOT reduction, tri-stats based on max HP, and spark up. A very interesting combination of defensive and offensive buffs. Cripple your opponent's stats while boosting your own. I would say use this UBB if you don't like additional damage at turn's end, which usually causes this. Bonding. Kahiki is bonded to Ciara, and their synergy is Miasma, which reduces the healing effects on a single enemy. Basically, you say no to healing. Best example is Fury and how we can fully negate rapid healing. Yeah, take that, you stupid piece of Dual Brave Burst Conflicted Philosophy. You get grand damage, almost all the damage buffs under the sun. Try stats based on max HP, forgettable normal hit count buffs. Evasion, attack and defense reduction, DOT, infliction, and reduction. As a DBB, this is not bad. There is actually a lot going on here, and to be honest, who knew the niche buffs from these two actually can make a very decent DBB? It was like they were meant for each other. Enhancements. As with all the VA units, there are options for PvP and PvE. The best part is option M. God bless. Anyways, here are my builds for Kahiki. So, is Kahiki good? The answer is... it depends. Kahiki is a very odd unit, considering his BB and SBB. He is a nuker, but also has a lot of spark support, so you kinda have to make sure your team is good with sparking to fully utilize Kahiki. Sparking is not very hard to do anyways, so I don't see anyone having major issues. Many people still prefer Charlie for her kit, but I still think Kahiki is still good for what he does. It is based on personal preference on who you would like to use on your water team after all. Kahiki is a little odd, but he will function well as your main nuker for your water squads. Thanks, summoners, and see you all for the next one.